even as a citizen, you could still have problems with immigration. And we're going to talk about the five main ways that you could get in trouble with immigration, even as a U.S. citizen. Even as a citizen, you can still have your citizenship revoked. There's five ways that you can lose them. And the reason that you could lose your citizenship in one of these situations is because they're pretty extreme circumstances. First one is basically if you committed a fraud during your naturalization process. You lied to an officer, you failed to disclose a crime, you failed to disclose a group, something that basically could have made an impact on your likelihood of being accepted or not as a citizen, that could be something that could cause the government to revoke your citizenship. Number two is if you fail to testify for Congress. Essentially, if you're called to testify for Congress as a naturalized citizen and you don't or you refuse unreasonably, then at that point they could start a denaturalization process against you. Number three is that if you're a member of a subversive group, if you're a part of a terrorist organization, a group that wants to overthrow the United States government, and they find this within the first 5 years of your naturalization or even after, they could start the denaturalization process against you and you could lose your citizenship. You need to be careful in who you associate yourself with, because some groups that you might think are not terrorist groups or subversive groups, they might have been considered by immigration in the past to be, and that could be a serious problem for you. The fourth is a dishonorable discharge from the military. If within the first 5 years of you having naturalized, you are dishonorably discharged from the military, you stand at risk of losing your citizenship. So you need to be very careful as a member of the armed forces how you conduct yourself in the military arena and make sure that you, if you have to depart the military service, that you do so in an honorable manner. Otherwise, you risk the fact that they could try to revoke your citizenship. Last but not least, does not always lead to a revocation of citizenship, but it could lead you to jail. If you commit fraud as a citizen, meaning you try to commit alien smuggling, you committed immigration fraud by marrying someone and try to give them papers or anything of the sort, you could be sent to jail on federal offenses, federal felonies, because of your actions. So sometimes, or a lot of times, these don't lead to you losing your green card, your citizenship, but it does lead to the possibility of you landing in jail for a long time. So these are some of the five main reasons why you need to be careful if you're a naturalized citizen and the certain actions that you take after you become a citizen. To know your rights and other things, we've always linked down below information that you can obtain to make sure that you're fully informed as to your rights and duties as a citizen. But other than that, if you have any questions, feel free to send us a private message. You can also leave a comment in this video, or you can contact us directly here at the office and we'll be happy to answer any questions you have. Thank you so much and have a great afternoon.